That's not me. You've got the wrong man.
Not according to Jesse Harris, who sold you a revolver.
We could bring him up from holding and have him identify you in person.
Fine. So what? I bought the gun. I needed it for protection. My first night here, some arsehole put a knife to my neck and stole my wallet. Took all the cash I had on me, almost slit my throat.
Okay, you say some person stole all your cash, but when we picked you up from the airport, you had this on you.
I said he stole all the cash I had on me at the time. This was all back at my hotel room.
10,000 British pounds. That's a lot to be carrying around, isn't it?
From a vacation, mate. Cash spends easier, and you can use it anywhere.
Like at the airport to buy a round-trip business class ticket to Los Angeles.
There's nothing illegal about that.
He's right. It's not against the law to carry cash, no matter how much.
Listen, I admit to buying the gun, but that doesn't matter, because I sold it a couple of days ago.
You sold it? To who? Why?
Some bloke in Venice. Didn't catch his name. Well, I couldn't very well take the revolver back to Manchester with me now, could I?
No, I guess you couldn't.
So that's how it all worked out, then?
No, not exactly. You see, the gun that you sold to some bloke
was used to murder this man, Robert Branson. And then the revolver was thrown into the Venice canals along with this, which was worn by the killer.
Now, in most cases, salt water would destroy useful evidence in clothing like this. But inside this ski mask, we found some hair follicles.
Means that we have the killer's DNA. And normally we would swab your cheek for a sample, wait 48 hours for the results, and then arrest you for murder. But in merry old England, whenever someone is convicted of a crime, and you have quite the history, sir, they are submitted to mandatory DNA testing. And guess whose profile is coming to us right now?
My hair couldn't be in that balaclava because I never wore it. And even if I did, just because it was in the same canal doesn't connect it to the gun.
What are you doing here?
I'm investigating an assault on a New York City police lieutenant that happened a couple of blocks from here.
We don't know anything about the cop getting beat up. Anybody else talking to you about it?
Why don't you let us worry about that?
We own these streets.
Yeah, I'm from here, my friend. These are my neighbors.
They are old, and their houses are ugly. If they are smart, they will sell cheap and get out while they still can.
Thanks for the tip. Maybe I'll come back with an offer for you.
So give me my wallet, and I'll pay the fine, and then I'm out of here.
Well, we have other matters to discuss. Like the assault of a New York City police lieutenant.
We've already been through this. My client denies all knowledge of the incident.
So stupid.
Actually, things have changed. We've been collecting complaints about your crew shaking down local store owners and trying to force homeowners into selling their houses cheap.
I'd say you're looking at 5 years minimum so far.
I pulled your rap sheet. You've been arrested 3 times before.
But never convicted.
Because no one ever crosses me.
In all 3 cases, you were arrested and released. In all 3 cases, the same confidential informant talked. That tells me the real reason you've never been convicted? You always snitch on your friends.
Those records are supposed to be sealed.
Think anybody's gonna care once the word's out in the street?
You give us everyone and everything, including your role in the assault of Lieutenant Gormley. This is a one-time offer. You blink, it's off the table.
Come on, Vlad. Don't pretend like you haven't done it before.
Can you at least make it look like I didn't break right away?
Howdy, ma'am. Can I help you?
You live here?
Sure do. Name's Jacob Dufour. I'm the owner of the farm. And you are?
Special Agent Tara Lewis of the FBI.